Marinetti. 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 Marinetti.
She wore blue,
once a horse was reflected in the glass, although I don't recall seeing that horse.
Marinetti was begun at the end of 1967 and completed 18 months later when it had a riotous world premiere in Sydney in June 1969. This was followed by a more orderly premiere in Perth in July 1969, on the exact day that the first men landed on the moon. Marinetti is the culmination of my work in the 1960s, which began in the theatre with productions from the Theatre of the Absurd, in particular the works of Alfred Jarry, Antonin Artaud and F.T. Marinetti. From Jarry I got the idea of the absurd, and from Artaud the belief that words could not be the dominant element in drama, while from Marinetti came the notion of the improvised happening and the minimization of plot and characterization. In 1965 I decided to shift my working mode from theatre to film and established Ubu Films, named after the absurd central character of Jarry's dramas. A number of short films followed, some of which you've seen in this current survey, which explored various aspects of the film medium, including montage, split screen, superimposition, and cameraless animation. At the same time, I collaborated with other artists associated with Ubu in the group medium of light shows, which combined my film and theatre experiments. A significant aspect of all this work in the 60s was the trend towards improvisation, the rejection of the literary basis of mainstream theatre and film, and the tendency towards abstraction, inspired by Kandinsky, Clay and Jackson Pollock. I began work on Marinetti with an abstract sequence that serves as its prelude. It was composed over a number of months to a mathematical formula using the unit of the film frame, 1/24th of a second, as the basic unit of development. Using clear and opaque film, I fashioned an introduction to the film that takes 14 minutes to build to the opening scene. This is a growth structure based on the development of perceptive awareness observed in audiences watching my earlier film, Bolero. During this prelude, the soundtrack introduces some of the ideas of futurism and its founder, F.T. Marinetti. I'd become interested in futurism during my research into the origins of the theatre of the absurd and was particularly taken by Marinetti's experiments in minimising plot and characterisation, in creating free verse, and in allowing music, lighting and colour to become equal elements of the creativity with words and performance. Over the next 12 months, I improvised scenes for the film using a wide variety of lighting, lenses and film speeds. I created montages in the camera by rewinding and re-exposing the film and used a split-screen mask and superimposition to create the interpenetration of forms that is the essence of futurism. The results were then edited into what became a continuous visual montage with an accompanying sound montage that included both free verse narration and a jazz rock music score improvised to the image. The completed film does have characters and plots, albeit minimal as Marinetti decreed. The conceit of the film is the notion of a camera turned back into the eye of the narrator and filming his stream of consciousness. It takes place at a party where the work of Marinetti is being discussed, but the narrator's mind wanders to the people in the room, and in particular, a former girlfriend, and then to his current girlfriend and the complexities of that relationship. Memory and fantasy dominate the present and lead to unbearable confusion, which causes the narrator to leave the party and wander city streets. But this proves no relief either, as memories continue to flood the mind. Eventually he rests and his troubles slowly abate as a new morning dawns. In creating such a film, I was doing no more than adopting the strategies used by early 20th century artists in introducing modernism to poetry, the novel, painting, theatre and music. But because equivalent experiments in film were so little known in Australia, and mainstream film still employed the aesthetics of the 19th century European academies, my film shocked its first audience. Now, while mainstream film is still based in 19th century academic aesthetics, many of the strategies I employed in Marinetti are commonplace and seen nightly on music television. Perhaps now the film can be appreciated for what it is.